Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Metropolis Radio. Today, we are doing kind of a pseudo follow-up to a video I did a couple of months ago, and that was on Blade Runner Black Lotus. Well, apparently the trailer and release date have been revealed. Adult Swim has unveiled a new trailer and an official release date for the first two episodes of its new animated series, Blade Runner Black Lotus. A new trailer and release date has been unveiled for the upcoming anime series, Blade Runner Black Lotus. The series, created in conjunction with Crunchyroll, is set in 2032 between the events of Ridley Scott's original Blade Runner and its 2017 sequel film, Blade Runner 2049. The show will also follow shortly on from the so-called Blackout, which saw the production of replicants banned and all electronic data erased. Black Lotus focuses on a female replicant named Elle, voiced by Jessica Henwick, and centers on her journey to reclaim her identity and lost memories. Other notable voice cast members include Stephen Root, Peyton List, Brian Cox, and Wes Bentley. Work on the animation was announced back in 2018, and the show is co-directed by, and I am gonna mispronounce this name like you wouldn't believe. The show is co-directed by Shinji Aramaki and Kenji Kamiyama. I didn't butcher them that bad. The English language version of the show will be aired by Adult Swim on Toonami, while Crunchyroll will debut a Japanese language version. Well, if I'm going to watch Blade Runner Black Lotus, I am going to watch dubbed. I am not going to watch subbed. I cannot watch subbed anime to save my life. It's really weird. I have to watch dubbed anime, but whenever I watch a movie like Legend of Drunken Master, or Police Story, I have to watch the dub, because what I can't stand is the mouth moving and it's just bup, 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 bup. I'm going to kick your ass. Now at New York Comic Con's the future of Blade Runner Black Lotus panel, Adult Swim shared a brand new trailer for the highly anticipated series, along with an official November 13th premiere date for the first two episodes. The panel included co-director Shinji Aramaki and Kenji Kamiyama, along with executive producer Joseph Chu, or is it Chow? It's either Chu or Chow. I'm gonna say Chu. And futurist Maurice Conti. In the trailer, audiences are returned to the classic sci-fi noir of Blade Runner's Los Angeles, as Elle is subjected to familiar Voight comp test. Later, she is heard to kill them all. And I am going to go ahead and play the trailer right here for you guys so that you could see it for yourself.
The people manna when heaven would not oblige. If a man is capable of stealing the credit for a feat of such enormity, I say, give him time.
Why are my dreams getting worse? What did you do to us?
Don't worry. I'm just gonna ask you some questions.
A loyal trouble-free companion, given to you upon arrival, absolutely free.
20 years ago, a corporation made artificial people. Call them replicants. Hoping they'd do all our heavy lifting without ever complaining.
Humanity would have starved without you. But ideas mean nothing without the money and power to actualize it.
Police units are en route.
Suspect is female, 20s.
LAPD, stop!
What are we up against?
You said you had it all under control.
How do you expect to control nature?
I know what I have to do. Kill them all.
All right, one of the biggest aspects that I like about that trailer over the teaser is that we finally get some, like, classic, like, noir jazz music in the beginning. But then, unfortunately, it goes into, like, some weird, like, millennial dubwub that's trying to be, like, 1940s jazz. You know, if you're gonna use the Blade Runner name, but you're not gonna use the aesthetics, then why bother calling it Blade Runner? You know, you need that jazz soundtrack from the first movie. Otherwise, the whole thing doesn't work as a noir. It just, in my opinion, straight up doesn't. But, you know, again, that could be only me. How do you guys feel about the millennial rub-a-dubba-wub-wub type music in the trailer? Personally, not a fan. But continuing on with the article, Black Lotus marks the franchise's first foray into an animated series with an indicated dedication to the sci-fi noir style that made the original film so successful. Again, if they keep that original jazz soundtrack, yes, but if they try to use that millennial rub-a-dubba-wub-wub, it ain't gonna fucking work. Expectations for the new show will be set relatively high as it explores new ground, while no doubt hoping to secure a strong viewership from longtime fans of the franchise. However, the original Blade Runner's reputation as Hollywood gold has proven to be no guarantee that success will follow in the wake of its sequels and spinoffs. Blade Runner 2049 failed to make a significant box office impression, despite its rave reviews and critical reception. However, it's worth noting that it also took time for Ridley Scott's original Blade Runner to receive the recognition it deserved. Again, the original Blade Runner bombed in theaters, became a huge hit on home video, then went back to being a cult classic. So, you know, but here's the thing that people don't bring up about Blade Runner 2049. Like, Blade Runner 2049 failed. Did Blade Runner 2049 need a $150 million budget behind it? Because personally, I think that's what was a big contributor to that movie failing at the time. Sandwiched neatly between the timelines of its cinematic predecessors, Blade Runner Black Lotus offers an exciting opportunity to fill the narrative gap in the Blade Runner universe, while also centering around the perspective of a known replicant with a whole host of characters and a leading protagonist whose story centers on the mystery of her past and purpose. The new animation has given itself a lot of leeway to win over fans. After the first two episodes are dropped on November 13th, audiences should have a much better idea of how faithful the series has remained to the films, while also injecting its own creative spin into the franchise. Now, how do I feel about Blade Runner Black Lotus? Like I said, that new trailer has given me more hope than that teaser has by, you know, bringing back that 1940s jazz soundtrack. As far as how the show is going to be, that's going to have to wait to be seen, because there is almost there's not much revealed narrative-wise within the trailer. And I think it's done on purpose, especially like if you're going to have the whole show be around, you know, this replicant trying to regain her past memories. You know, you don't want to reveal too much in the trailer. Otherwise, what's the point of watching the damn show? And guys, that's pretty much all I've got for you right now. If you stuck around this long, thanks so much for doing so. And if you've been following me long enough, you know I'm terrible at ending these videos, so I will just see you guys next time.